Hey babe, I'm in the living room. You know, I was thinking tonight we could babe? Baby? What's wrong? Baby. Baby, please open the door. Please let me in. Okay. I'm gonna go back down the hall, give you your space. Just tell me when you're ready, okay? Baby, what happened? Please don't do that. Don't tell me that you're okay when you're not. No, you're not. Your body is tense, and your fingers are shaking. And at every sound, you're darting your eyes around this room, assessing danger. Baby, we're in our room, in our house. We're safe. Because I'm willing to bet you had flashbacks. The fireworks, they triggered it. It's probably even worse because we weren't expecting them this time of year. Just waiting for you to let me in, because every instinct and bone in my body is yelling at me to come across this room and hold you tight and to tell you that everything's gonna be okay, that you're safe, and do everything to take that pain from you. And the only thing stopping me is that I'm trying to respect your space. I'm not sure if you think that by letting me in, you're admitting to some kind of weakness, or that you're trying to protect me, or God forbid not be a burden. And none of those things are true. Admitting having flashbacks and to still cope with PTSD does not make you a weak person. It takes, in fact, a lot of strength to say. And while I appreciate the gesture that you're trying to protect me, I don't need protection from you. You feel safe enough to open up to me. Baby, please look at me. I'm gonna touch your face, okay? Baby, look at me. No, this isn't pity. This is empathy. Empathy because it's painful to see you in pain while you try to tell me it's not there. I want to help. I want to help you carry the burden. No. Understand this. You, as a person, as my person, are never a burden. Ever. What you are going through is the burden. And you don't have to do it alone. I'm right here. And while I can never imagine what you went through over there, You're here. And we're safe in our bedroom. And I will do everything in my power every day to remind you that you are safe with me. And that you never need to hide this. No, it's not a cliche. I'm not just saying it because everybody says it. I'm saying it because I choose to, and because I believe it. Relationships are not one-sided. There's not one strong person and one person who needs the strength. It's a give and take. It's a two-way street. Because I love you. For better, for worse, right? Just because we haven't made official vows doesn't mean they're not real to me. I didn't get into this relationship looking for a way out. I knew what your job was from the very beginning. I knew you'd leave on tour. And I prayed every day you'd come back. Baby, please, it's okay. Let it go. I wasn't expecting to hug that tight. It's okay, it's okay. Shh, it's okay. Baby, let it out. Let it out. Lay down, okay? Come on. Yeah, we'll just get comfy here in the blankets. Come on. No. Don't worry about anything else tonight. Come on. Just keep rubbing your back. It's okay. Just let it out. Let it all out, babe. I've got you. I've got you right here. Just stroke your hair. Rub your back. Hold you as close as I can.